some Bible teaching, healing, deliverance, prophetic word, spiritual and physical breakthrough, impartation from the Holy Spirit. Come and be blessed. All are invited. Holy Spirit Conference. Come and experience the power of God. Global Light Revival presents Inner City Holy Spirit Conference with host Prophet Eric Isaiah.
When the Spirit of God is leading you to do something, and you follow and you obey and you do it the way the Holy Spirit wants you to do it, you become a son of God.
Newcastle, date Monday 16th and Tuesday 17th of May 2016. Time 6:30 p.m. each night. Venue Britannia Hotel, Newcastle Airport, Walsingham Pontland, Newcastle upon Tyne, NE13 8DJ. Nottingham, date Thursday 19th to Friday the 20th of May 2016. Time 6:30 p.m. each night. Venue Britannia Nottingham Hotel, 1 St James's Street, Nottingham, NG1 6BN. Liverpool, date Monday 23rd to Tuesday 24th of May 2016. Time 6:30 p.m. each night. Venue Liverpool Hope University, Eden Building, Hope Park, Liverpool, L16 9LD. Manchester, 25th of May at 6 p.m. at Methodist Central Hall, Oldham Street, Manchester, M1 1JQ. London, 27th to 29th of May, 290 West Green Road, N15 3QR. Sheffield, 29th of May, 5:30 at Copthorne Hotel, Sheffield United Football Grounds, Bramall Lane, Sheffield, S2 4SU. For information, call 07947 476 649, 07401 664 977, www.globallightrevival.com. Come for your powerful Word of God, awesome Bible teaching, healing, deliverance, prophetic word, spiritual and physical breakthrough, impartation from the Holy Spirit. Come and be blessed. All are invited. Holy Spirit Conference. Come and experience the power of God.
Oh, praise the Lord for what the Lord is doing. Whoever you are watching this program tonight, I believe that there is a night designed for your blessing, a night designed for your divine emancipation, a night designed for your freedom. So wherever you are watching the program, I want you to count yourself blessed, because God is about to show forth his power in your life, and your entire family is going to have a big testimony as we are in this weekend. And I'm trusting God that no matter what you're going through in life, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, will touch your life, and your life will never remain the same. I'm so excited coming your way today. My name is Eric Isaiah, the senior pastor of Global Light Revival Church. We meet at the 290 West Green Road, N15 3QR, Tottenham. And we have a branch also in Sheffield, where we do every Sunday evening in Sheffield, London every Sunday morning and afternoon, and Sheffield every Sunday evening, and in Manchester every Wednesday evening, and in Edinburgh, Scotland, every Wednesday evening as well. We've seen the move of God so mightily. We've seen God touching lives and restoring lives. And I want to take this opportunity to let you understand that regardless of where you are, what you belong, what you believe, what is going on in your life, you just connect to God and you will see the glory of God. You know, many people run away from God, but I want you to run to God. And when you run to God, God is going to see you through and is going to touch your life. Last night, we had an amazing honor. We saw the power of God, incredible move of God, and we saw testimonies. And I want you to understand that when God begins to move, no man can resist God. Therefore, just give your life to God, tune in to God, and when God begins to move in your life, no one can resist you. You know, I love the story of a young man called Jephthah in the book of Judges. The Bible said that his brothers rejected him. They made him an outcast because his mother was a harlot. And the Bible said that one day there were a battle of three nations against them. And they said, we need a man to come and stand and fight for us. So they went in and they brought in this man, and he stood in and he fought for them and he won and he became their leader. What am I trying to tell you tonight is that no matter what you've been through in life, there is a room for God to make amends, and make you whom he wants you to be. You were created in the image and the likeness of God, and therefore God has something, his DNA is placed inside of you. The potential of God is inside of you. The abilities and the capabilities of God is placed inside of you. Therefore, you can make it in life, and don't give up, don't throw in the towel. Don't tell yourself that it is over, because the best is yet to come. And I want you to rise up again on your feet and say to yourself, yet though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. That is my teaching for today. Yet though I walk through, in Psalm 23, say, yet though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. What does that mean? Means that one way or the other, you end up walking through the valley of the shadow of death like Jephthah. He walked through it, but at the end of the day, God brought him back to where he wanted him to be. I want to declare over somebody's life tonight that there's a place that God wanted to be. There is a plan and a purpose for your life and for your destiny. So don't give up. Don't throw in the towel. Just stand strong and stand tall and believe that faithful is he who has called you, and he will bring his purpose and his plans concerning your life to divine accomplishment. So the word for tonight is that, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. Meaning that there will be evil there. That is why Jesus taught us the Lord's Prayer, and he used one particular word that I love so much. So when you're praying, remember to say this word, deliver us from evil. Meaning that there's evil, but you pray for deliverance out of the hands of the evil. And David said, yet though I'm walking through it, I'll fear no evil because the Lord is with me. Friends, God is with you. God is on your side. And don't be afraid of what is happening in this end time, in this evil, dying world. As a child of God, you must stand strong and stand tall and believe that he that has called you, he that created you, have something better for your life. Hello, call on the line. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, how are you?
Hi, Pastor. I am fine with Peter, but I am in need of prayer.
All right. What do you want God to do for you, please?
Especially for my ex-husband and family. His mother is practicing of witchcraft.
Mm.
And she has basically destroyed our marriage with cursing us from the beginning. I was distant from the Lord, unfortunately. I didn't pray. I came to the Lord afterwards. I got depressed. And after 2 years, our daughter was 2 years old when he divorced me. And then she made every effort to separate us even more, because she has the very controlling nature, and she didn't like the fact that her son, her favorite son, was married to me, and that she couldn't control me somehow. My mom was always praying for me. My mom is a Christian, and she was praying for me, for God to access me and deliver me from that environment. And eventually I left him after being very ill. He became very horrible. And not too long ago, he physically hit me. And now we are at the court. The judge will decide who is going to raise the child. But I really pray to God to deliver him and make him a safe man.
Okay.
And his mother and his father, I just need them to be safe for the sake of my daughter.
All right.
And, on the 6th of July, we have a hearing at the court. And
all
I
right.
hope to be able to have my daughter with me.
Okay, I'm going to pray for you. Where are you calling from, please?
I'm calling from Hampshire.
Hampshire. All right. I'm going to pray for you. And I believe that God is going to bring restoration. Whatever has gone on in your life, in the relationship, in that marriage, whatever you're saying is a witchcraft they're throwing on you, by the power in the name of Jesus Christ, it will never have any effect on you. Therefore, Lord, I pray for your daughter. I rebuke any attack of the enemy. And I pray for total deliverance. The Bible says that, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Father, I pray for your hand of comfort to touch the life of your daughter. And I hear the Lord saying to me that I should tell you that don't let the past put fear in you.
Amen.
Hey, listen to me. Because as I'm ministering to you, I just see like the spirit of fear want to take over. And sometimes it might even affect your sleeping pattern. But the Lord is ministering to me that I should tell you that don't let fear take over, because he is doing a new thing in your life after today's prayer.
Amen.
A shackle is being broken out of your life, and you're going to see the glory of God.
Amen.
Father, I thank you. You know one thing? God is going to connect you to a woman. I see a woman who's like a woman of God. The name is Susan. Susan. Susan.
Yes.
Susan. Susan. Yes. I see this woman standing in the gap for you, and I see her holding your hand, and she was praying for you.
Amen.
And the Lord is ministering to me that this woman is a woman of God that is going to use to build up a bridge that has been broken already. Now that I'm talking, that fear has caused a lot of things. But the Lord is saying to me, after tonight, God has not given you the spirit of fear, but of power, of sound mind, and of love.
Yes.
Therefore, I declare over your life, sound mind, power, love over you right now. May the sound mind of Jehovah, may the peace of Elohim, and may the love of Christ Jesus encapsulate your entire life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I call it done. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. God bless
Amen.
You.
Amen.
And I hope to see you one day in one of our meetings, okay? All right, God bless you. Ladies and gentlemen, we bless God for what God is doing. You know, he said, yea, though I walk through the valley. So remember this word, no matter how life is, there will be a valley experience. If you've not had your valley experience, be careful how you treat people who've gone through the valley or who are going through the valley. Because it is the grace of God that picks people from the valley and places them back on the mountaintop. So in your life, you one day go through your valley experience. But the Bible said that, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. I want to encourage somebody who is watching the program today that no matter what you're going through, do not fear evil. Do not fear what evil trying to do. Just hold on to God and believe that he is a good God. He is a loving Father. His grace is sufficient for you and whatever you're going through. His love is as vast as a mighty ocean. I want to encourage you that he is about to do something new in your life. He is about to do something unique in your life. He's about to blow your mind. He's about to give you a shock of a miracle, because what you're moving through, where trials, tribulation, where the turbulence, where the enemy try to bring you down and make you feel like you are nothing, he says that, my son, my daughter, I am with you. In that valley, I am there with you. In that experience, I am there with you. I will not leave you, neither would I forsake you, because I have a better future for your life and for your destiny. David said, here do I walk through. Friends, don't give up when you're going through it. Don't commit suicide. There's a lady, you're watching the program right now. You are thinking, you're contemplating suicide. The Lord is telling me to tell you, don't commit suicide, because greater is the future than the past. There's a couple. I see a couple watching the program. There's a confusion in your marriage right now. And the confusion is because you've been married for ages now, and there's no the fruit of the womb. Means that you've not had a child yet. And you are confused and you are battling about this case. And I hear God saying to me that, be patient, because he's about to give you a surprise. In the year 2016, I mean this year, God is going to give you a mind-blowing miracle. There's a gentleman, I hear your name, Joseph. Joe. Joseph, listen to this word. I see you had an accident before. And it runs to the spirit. There is an accident that is also plan, and you've dreamt about it three times. You have three dreams of you having an accident. So it has put like a fear in you. But God says, I should pray with you. I should break that power of that accident. And it should never be your portion in Jesus Christ's name. And I declare you free in Jesus' name. Amen. Hello.
Hello, man of God. Good evening.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm blessed to hear from you, man of God.
How are you?
I'm blessed, man of God.
All right. Please, your name, where are you calling from?
My name is Elizabeth. I'm calling from London.
Your name is?
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth.
Yes, man of God.
Wonderful. Can I pray for you before we talk, okay?
Please.
Because as you called me right now, I saw in the realms of the spirit, I saw the hand of God coming upon you.
Amen.
But the hand touched your stomach, the left side of your stomach. And I asked the Holy Spirit, what is that for? And the Lord said to me, it's something to do with a surgical operation. Amen. But the Lord is ministering to pray against it right now.
Amen.
Otherwise, there will be a situation whereby they will tell you that you are developing a growth in your tummy.
Yes, man of God.
Have they told you already?
Yes, I have a fibroid.
Your GP told you?
Yes, man of God.
But as I see the hand there right now, it means that God, by his supernatural power, is working on you now.
Amen.
To be precise, a shift to the left side of your stomach. I'm praying for you right now.
Amen.
That growth, that fibroid, that is inside of you, I command that thing to melt in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We are serving the living God who performs miracles.
Amen.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, you revealed to me at the studio here, and your daughter just confirmed it. Therefore, based on this thing, I take authority by the mandate conferred on me in the name of Jesus. And I break the power of the enemy right now. I silence the voice of the devil right now. And I declare total healing right now. In Jesus' name, amen. You know one thing? Where are you calling from, please?
London, man of God.
I would love you, if possible, to be at the meeting tomorrow, okay?
Yes, man of God.
Because what God has revealed, we need to have prayed for you. But we need to spend time anointing you. Bible said that, and the anointing shall break the yoke.
Amen.
So that we can deal with the thing to the root cause.
Amen.
My God, I thank you. I don't know why I'm speaking to you here in England, but I see a vision, and I see a place like Paris. No, Paris in France.
Paris in France.
In France. And I see in the realms of the spirit, someone standing there in the realms of the spirit, saying that, why should she get her deliverance? I'm praying for you. Whoever, what you are experiencing now, the cause of it is one thing. You dreamt some time ago, and you were given food and meat to eat. Are you there?
Yes, my
friend. And that is what has developed the fibroid. But tomorrow I'll meet you and we'll deal with the case, okay?
Amen.
May the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Because
Amen.
Otherwise it will cause problem even in your marriage.
Amen.
But I'll see you tomorrow. God bless you.
Okay, I'm believing God for marriage as well.
Pardon?
I'm believing God for marriage.
Yeah, that's what I've mentioned at the last bit of it. So tomorrow when I see you, we'll go into details of it, okay?
Amen. Thank
Wonderful.
You.
God bless you. Friends, you can send a text message to the mobile numbers here, and you can also call us live on the studio number. If you are in Newcastle, I want to encourage you from the 16th to the 17th of this month of May, I will be in Newcastle. And I know that the power of God is going to be so strong and tangible, and we are going to see the glory of God as never before. Glory be to God. We are going to see men set free, people being saved, people being healed. If anyone is sick in a wheelchair, in crutches, blind, carry them and bring them. And we will demonstrate the power of the Most High God. We are not disputing the fact of medical doctors, no. But there are some things that go beyond medical doctors, that Jesus, the Alpha and Omega, the one who is called Jehovah Rapha, Our God, our healer, will touch you and heal you in the name of Jesus Christ. So I want to invite you to Newcastle on the 16th and the 17th, and to Nottingham, and also to Liverpool. And it's going to be an awesome move of God. And I can't wait to see you there, because God is going to show forth in his supernatural power as never before. Hello, caller on the line.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Please, your name, where are you calling from?
Please, I'm calling from Belgium. My name is Theophilus.
From Belgium?
Yes, please.
How is Belgium today?
Oh, Belgium, the nice weather today, 26 degrees.
It's great.
Amen.
Wonderful for you in Belgium.
Amen. Thank you so much.
As I'm speaking to you right now, I just saw a letter written in the realms of the spirit.
Amen.
And what my eye can see in a vision is business.
Amen.
And under the business, I saw two different pages. One side is import and one side is exports.
Amen.
And I saw further, and I saw car and car spare parts.
Amen.
And the Lord said to me that I have called you to do my work.
Amen.
But I'm also going to attach business to it for you.
Amen.
And the business, literally, it wasn't even in Belgium. I saw you traveling to Germany and Denmark.
Amen.
And you started shipping things from there to Africa.
Amen.
My God, I thank you.
Amen.
I don't know, but this is what I'm seeing. And the Lord said to me, I should pray for you, because he's going to cause you to emerge into greatness as never before. But remember, the first one is the work of God.
Amen.
And the business follows. Don't take the business first.
Amen.
And Father, I thank you for the life of my dear friend.
Jesus' name.
I don't know why I'm seeing a gentleman. I'm seeing two men, right? One bears a name like David, right? Thank you, Father.
Amen.
David. And he looks like a pastor, as I see in the vision. And one bears a name like John, but they'll call him like Johnny, J-O-H-N-N-Y.
Yes.
I don't know who that person is, right? J-O-H-N-N-Y.
Amen. Yes, Johnny, I may have met them, but I met a lot of pastors, but I cannot remember the name of them, some of them, maybe. I'm sorry.
Okay. You said you met a lot of pastors, but you cannot remember the names.
Hello?
Hello, you said you cannot remember the names.
Yes, please.
Okay, I'm going to pray for you for the specifics so that you meet them within this month and you see the glory of God.
Amen.
Father God, I unfold this mystery to your son.
Amen.
Let it be a supernatural manifestation.
Jesus' name.
Father, I uncover, my God, that Johnny is having a background from Congo background. That is where that Johnny comes from. His background is Congo. Father, now I thank you, Lord. I praise you for the life of my dear friend. I release these open doors for him.
Amen.
And I speak favor over your life.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I call it an amen.
Now I remember. Perfect.
Okay, talk to me. I'm listening to you.
The journey you're talking. Now, I remember when you pray, I remember that I met him in France.
You met him in France?
In France.
And where is he from in France?
He's from Congo. When you mentioned Congo, and I remember.
So, you know that God is connecting you right now.
In Jesus' name, amen.
And his name is Johnny.
Amen.
And he comes from Congo. He lives in France. You met
amen.
Him?
Amen. It is.
Pardon?
It is true. We met in France.
Okay.
We met in France.
Okay.
Behind Paris, we met. It is true.
All right.
We met there. So, yes.
So I'm going to bless your life for the business God has given you, okay?
Amen. And, Prophet.
Yes, sir.
My wife also is here, is having a leg pain from almost over a year now. I am praying over it, and nothing is coming. No result is coming. It can't work.
Wonderful. Okay. Amen. If she can't walk right now, as you've called this program,
amen,
by the prophetic grace and apostolic grace upon my life,
amen,
I give you 2 minutes. Your wife is going to walk.
Amen.
Give the phone to your wife, please.
Come and take the phone.
Give the phone to your wife.
Praise the Lord, Pastor.
Mama, how are you?
Please, I'm fine.
Okay. Put your hands on where the leg that is not functioning properly. Put your hands there.
I did.
Because God said to me, in 2 minutes, I'm timing my, in 2 minutes, you are going to walk.
Amen.
Okay?
Amen.
In two Amen. Minutes, you are going to walk.
Amen.
You see, we have fathers Amen. That moves Amen. In a strong healing ministry.
Amen.
Prophetic and deliverance.
Amen.
And when you have fathers connected to that realm,
Amen.
It's easy for you to flow.
Amen.
So, Father, by the covenant you have with me and you have with my fathers,
Amen.
By the calling you called me whilst I was in my mother's womb,
Amen.
By the ordination ordained by one national healing evangelist,
Amen.
I tap into the realms of the supernatural healing right now.
Amen.
And I speak into the life of your daughter right now.
Amen.
Now, the leg that is not functioning, I command
Amen.
The leg to be healed now in the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. The leg, receive power right now.
Amen.
God, remember, you gave Amen. The husband a prophetic word. He was even confused.
Amen.
I have to mention the name and go into details and the country before he got to know that it's true. Father,
Amen.
That same power, let that power Amen. Come upon his wife right now.
Amen.
Let that same power come upon his life, his wife's legs right now.
Amen.
And I call
Amen.
Upon the God of my many journeys who has
Amen.
Kept me to this age.
Amen.
And I declare, Mama, your leg is healed now.
Amen.
Stand up and begin to walk. Stand up
Amen.
And begin to do what you couldn't do. Right now.
Amen.
Right now. Get up. Stand up, please. Stand up.
Please, I'm doing it. I'm walking in Jesus' name.
You are walking?
Yes.
Begin to walk. My God.
Yes. I'm walking in Jesus' name.
You are walking?
Yes, please. Yes. Amen.
My God. Amen. Give the phone to your husband. Let me ask him.
Hold on, please.
My God. Hello,
Amen.
Sir.
Amen.
What is happening?
Oh, he's walking now. He's
walking
in the
now.
Name of the Lord Jesus.
Say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Now tell her to run, because from
he
walking,
says,
you got
to run.
He
said to run, run.
Tell her to run in the house.
Amen. It's running.
Oh, my God. I give you praise.
Amen. It's running.
Father, I give you
it's
praise.
Running. It's running now.
Father, I give you praise.
Amen.
So
in
you see, the power of God is at work right
you.
Now.
We give you the glory.
Say thank
we
you, Jesus.
Jesus, mighty name.
Say thank
Amen.
You, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
I want the two of you to shout the biggest thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Wonderful. God bless you, Belgium.
Amen.
God bless
Amen.
You.
Amen.
And may
Amen.
God give you more package and more blessings in
Amen.
Jesus' name.
Also to you too.
Amen.
Amen.
Take my mobile number and call me later, okay?
Okay,
this is your testimony. For 1 year, and within 2 minutes, God has done it. This is the
Amen.
God we are serving. God bless you.
Okay.
God bless you.
Amen.
Bye-bye. My
Bye-bye.
God, what a mighty God we serve. The God of miracles and the God of wonders. Father God, I thank you for this tangible miracle that you've done on Olive TV today. I give you praise and I give you glory, Lord. For you alone deserve the glory. I praise you, Father. In Jesus' name, amen. Yet though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, don't be afraid, for God is with you. And if God is for you, who can be against you? Friends, I want to take this opportunity. You see prophecy, you see miracles. Signs and wonders, follow them that believe. You can also have the same anointing. Trust in Jesus. Give your life to Christ. And I promise you, he will use to do extraordinary things. I want to take this opportunity and invite you to Global Light Revival Church. Tomorrow, Sunday morning, 9 a.m., afternoon, 2 p.m. Sheffield branch, I'll be there 5:30 p.m. in the evening. Then I'll be in Manchester on Wednesday, 6 p.m. Edinburgh, every last Wednesday of the month. We see the power of God moving, and we see the glory of God being manifested here on live on this studio. And I want to encourage you, please, no matter how you think your life is messed up, the love of God is available, the grace is available to welcome you back to himself. And I want to take the opportunity for you to really, really understand that living a life without Christ is full of crisis. But you just connect yourself to Christ and you will see the glory of God. I know some of you are calling our mobile numbers right now. We can't pick it. You can send a text after the program. Here, you can call the mobile phone numbers. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Please, your name, where are you calling from?
My name is Akosha. I'm calling from Wembley.
Akosha from Wembley?
Yes, sir.
Akosha from Wembley. Wonderful. Akosha, what do you want to do for you?
I want God's favor on my education. I'm at uni at the moment, and I want his favor to be upon me as I continue to study.
Okay.
Second year.
Okay, Akosha, I'm going to pray for you.
Thank you.
The power of God is going to come upon your life.
Amen.
You're going to encounter the presence of God as never before.
Amen.
But I don't know why, as I'm going to pray for you, I saw an angel of the Lord that entered into a hospital.
Okay.
Right? And the Lord is ministering to me that I should pray for you. I'm not saying you are sick, no. But there is something that I see people working in the hospital.
I'm studying nursing.
You're studying nursing?
So, yeah, I do my placement at a hospital.
You do your placement in the hospital?
Yes.
That's what I say, you're not sick, but they were working. A work was going on.
Yes.
And so you are a nurse?
Yes. Yeah,
okay.
Nurse.
Or a student nurse, let me put it that way.
Yeah.
I'm going to pray for you. One thing that God wants me to tell you is that after your job, work will become easier and you will escalate. Promotion upon promotion shall be your portion.
Amen. Amen.
It looks like in the realms of the spirit, there was a battle that wanted them to trade you or like to fail something so that you will either repeat or you come off the course and be discouraged.
Yeah.
But the Lord is ministering to me that I should tell you. Because I see in a vision, I see you wearing like a school uniform, and the color I see is like green, it have a green background. And I asked the Holy Spirit, the Lord said to me that it's not a school uniform here in England, but it's like something that has gone in Africa. So you will dream a dream and you see yourself in your former school and someone like writing an exams.
Oh, okay. Because my secondary school in Africa, my uniform was green.
Your uniform was green?
Yes, it was.
Your secondary school in Africa, your uniform was green.
Yeah.
Is that true?
Yeah, that's true. That's
yeah, that is what I'm seeing. You weren't a uniform, not in England, but it's a school you attended in Africa. So in a spirit of setback, so they're putting the old uniform on you to set you back. And God said to me, Eric, break that power of the spirit of setback. And this lady is going to excel in her academics.
Amen.
Father, thank you for the life of Akosua.
Amen.
I'm praying for you, but the Holy Ghost is wanting me to pray for another name like Joyce, J-O-Y-C-E. And as I'm praying for you, but that lady, she's not a nurse, she's like a hairdresser. But I'm going to pray for you that anyone that wants to cut your hair, which will also come in a dream that you dream, you see that somebody's trying to cut your hair. I pray against that spirit right now.
Amen.
May the glory of God be strong over your life.
Amen.
May you excel. I take off that your former secondary school uniform. That is the color green. I take it off your life.
Amen.
And I declare you blessed and highly favored.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Please, Wembley is not far. Try and come to meeting tomorrow, 9 a.m. Okay. Let me see you in person so I can anoint you to seal this prophecy, okay?
Okay.
God bless you, sister. God bless you.
God bless you.
Bye-bye. Friends,
bye.
I'm going to take the advert for the upcoming event for just 1-2 minutes, and I'll be back to pick up the phone calls again. So keep on calling. Let's play the advert, and let's watch the event, upcoming event in the cities of United Kingdom, and be part of it, and the Lord will bless you. So I'll be with you in a minute. God bless you and stay tuned.
Global Light Revival presents Inner City Holy Spirit Conference with host Prophet Eric Isaiah.
When the Spirit of God is leading you to do something, and you follow and you obey and you do it the way the Holy Spirit wants you to do it, you become a son of God.
Newcastle, date Monday 16th and Tuesday 17th of May 2016. Time 6:30 p.m. each night. Venue Britannia Hotel, Newcastle Airport, Walsington Pontland, Newcastle upon Tyne, NE13 8DJ. Nottingham, date Thursday 19th to Friday the 20th of May 2016. Time 6:30 p.m. each night. Venue Britannia Nottingham Hotel, 1 St James's Street, Nottingham, NG1 6 p.m. Liverpool, date Monday 23rd to Tuesday 24th of May 2016. Time 6:30 p.m. each night. Venue Liverpool Hope University, Eden Building, Hope Park, Liverpool, L16 9LD. Manchester, 25th of May at 6 p.m. at Methodist Central Hall, Oldham Street, Manchester, M1 1JQ. London, 27th to 29th of May, 290 West Green Road, N15 3QR. Sheffield, 29th of May, 5:30 at Copthorne Hotel, Sheffield United Football Grounds, Bramall Lane, Sheffield, S2 4SU. For information, call 07947 476 649, 07401 664 977, www.globallightrevival.com. Come for your powerful Word of God, awesome Bible teaching, healing, deliverance, prophetic word, spiritual and physical breakthrough, impartation from the Holy Spirit. Come and be blessed. All are invited. Holy Spirit Conference. Come and experience the power of...
Our friends, we bless God for what God is doing. And I have some text messages here. So before I leave the studio, I'm going to read all your text messages and pray with you and also stand with you, support you in prayer. And I believe that God will do a great thing. Also, if you want to come to our counseling section one-on-one that we do every Tuesday in London, you can text a counseling appointment. They will give you date and time for your appointment. If you're in Yorkshire area or Manchester and you want to come to our office every Monday in Sheffield, you can also text the same thing and you tell us where you are, and they will give you the appointment. And I believe that, you see, one-on-one is very powerful. Prophetic, we see a woman coming for counseling. One-on-one came with crutches. The power of God came upon her so strong, she left without her crutches. Last night, she came for the all-night. She was giving testimony. Those who had all-night, you saw her. Somebody who was in crutches that God healed, went to hospital. They did a biopsy 3 times. They didn't find anything in their body. God restored her 100%. Friends, I believe in God who performed miracles. And it's your time for you to encounter your miracle. And I believe 2016, you will have the best that God has in store for you. We just started the month of May. And today is just the first, we are still the first week, the month of May. So just relax and believe God. The fifth month, the month of grace, you are going to encounter God's power. Hello.
God bless you, man of God.
God bless you. How are you?
I'm fine, sir. Please, man of God, I want to pray for me that God should remember me.
Please, your name, where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Ireland.
From where?
From Dublin.
Dublin. How are you in Dublin?
I'm fine, sir.
You know, we have an amazing ministry in Dublin. We'll still be doing our monthly event. So please,
I can't wait.
Keep in touch, okay?
Yes, sir.
At the Lewis Fitzgerald Hotel. Nurse Road, Dublin D22.
Yes, sir.
All right, so I'm praying for you right now. Excuse me, are you married?
Yes, sir.
Where's your husband?
He's with me.
I'm going to pray for the two of you.
Yes, sir.
Because in the realms of the spirit, I saw, whilst I was about to pray for you, I saw like the ring on both fingers, on your finger, the ring, I saw two rings, that both rings on one finger. And I saw the ring was broken. That's why I'm asking you whether you're married. So I'm going to pray for the two of you. Then I'm going to also pray for you that God is going to protect the fruit of your womb.
Yes, sir.
I don't know how many children you have now.
I need more, sir.
You want God to give you more?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'm going to pray for you as well, because spiritually, but I don't know, but I saw only two children first.
You are right.
How many do you have now?
Two, sir.
You have two children now.
Yes, sir.
Because I saw only two children, and I'm going to pray for you. By the power of God, if you need more, I'm going to pray for more for you.
Amen.
Father, I pray for your daughter right now.
Yes,
and
Lord.
I pray for the husband.
Amen.
I pray for supernatural grace.
Amen.
I pray for favor.
Amen.
Bless them beyond limitation.
Amen.
Let power come upon this marriage.
Amen.
Protect this marriage as never before.
Amen.
Let them see supernatural manifestation of your power, God.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father God, I thank you for blessing this family.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Can I speak to your husband?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Father. I give you praise. So how are you?
Hello, sir.
How are you doing?
I'm fine, sir. Thank you.
You see, God wants me to pray for you. I saw in the spirit, I saw like a table, and I saw like a medical doctor.
Okay.
Standing beside it, and he was trying to place medications on the table for you.
Okay.
Means that if you don't pray, they'll give you medication that you'll be taking every day. I have no idea whether you've been to any checkup so far.
Yeah.
When did you go for the checkup?
I even have an appointment for this Friday.
Friday?
Next Friday, yeah.
And do you still have an appointment again?
Yes.
Okay. Did they give you medications that you'll be taking every day?
No.
Okay.
Yet.
Pardon?
They've not given me any medication yet.
Okay. So you'll be going for the next appointment?
Yes, on Friday.
On Friday, because I saw a doctor with you giving you medication, and there were three different types of medication. But they can't literally see what is wrong with you. I'm going to pray for you. Anything that will attack your blood system, anything that will attack your heart, diabetes, high blood pressure, whatever they can call them,
yes.
By the power of the Holy Ghost, I'm going to break it right now.
Amen.
Because if you don't pray, the doctor will write, I see the doctor writing a report saying that you have diabetes and high blood pressure and things like that. What checkup did you go for?
It's for heart.
For your heart?
Yes.
Okay. So I'm going to pray for you right now.
Okay.
I'm going to rebuke the power of the enemy.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I silence the voice of the enemy, sickness out of his life.
Amen.
I prophesy over your life. When you go for checkup on Friday, they will not find anything in your body.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, I call it done. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
God bless man of God.
I'll see you in Dublin. God bless you. Bye-bye. Friends, time is almost up. One thing I want to do is that I want to read all the text messages. Then after that, I'll pray a prayer with you. And the text messages was a good evening. Please pray for me so my divine eye dimension power can fully manifest. Wow. You already see visions. God made a way for my business also to prosper. Okay. You didn't add your name, but I'll pray for you. And there's another one. Hello, man of God, please pray for me and my children. Okay. I'll pray for you and your children. One is a good evening, man of God. Please pray for my health. Thank you, Pam. Okay, Pam, I'll pray for you. And it's a good evening, man of God. Please pray for me and my health. The same person. All right. And I said, please pray for my people. Segun, I'll pray for you. Pastor, please pray for my court case of divorce settlement. All right, I'll pray for you. And one here is Anna. I say, man of God, want prayer for me and my family. Two want a husband and other a wife. Okay, two of them want husband and other wife. Two need jobs and me, I need papers. Here, my name is Anne. Anne, I'll pray for you. God will honor you. Good evening, sir. Tonya Shilongo and my husband, Daniel. I've been in Canada for 8 years, citizenship has rejected twice. I want the Lord to reunite us. I am in Africa. I am in Africa with the kids. Okay, God will remember you, my dear from Africa. God will remember you. God will remember you. Prophet, please pray for me. My son will get into secondary school. I will be going for papers soon. Thanks. Also, please pray that I pass my master's course. Lakwo from Essex. Father, I pray for all the text messages. I pray for supernatural miracle, breakthrough, open heavens. I prophesy over your life. May you receive blessing and may you receive all your papers. May you receive all your miracles. And those watching who could even text, I declare blessings over your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, may you be blessed in Jesus' name. One last word I want you to understand is that tomorrow is Sunday. Find a Bible-believing church and get yourself connected. If you're in London, I welcome you to Global Light Revival Church, 9 a.m. and 2 p.m. If you're in Yorkshire area and Sheffield, I welcome you to our Sheffield branch. If you're in Manchester, Wednesday, I welcome you over there. I know that your life will never remain the same. God bless you. I'll be here same time next week. I say bye-bye. And stay connected in Jesus' name. Amen.
Presents Inner City Holy Spirit Conference with host Prophet Eric Isaiah.
When the Spirit of God is leading you to do something and you follow and you obey and you do it the way the Holy Spirit wants you to do it, you become a son of God.
Newcastle, date Monday 16th and Tuesday 17th of May 2016. Time 6:30 p.m. each night. Venue Britannia Hotel, Newcastle Airport, Walsington Pontland, Newcastle upon Tyne, NE13 8DJ. Nottingham, date Thursday 19th to Friday the 20th of May 2016. Time 6:30 p.m. each night. Venue Britannia Nottingham Hotel, 1 St James's Street, Nottingham, NG1 6BN. Liverpool, date Monday 23rd to Tuesday 24th of May 2016. Time 6:30 p.m. each night. Venue Liverpool Hope University, Eden Building, Hope Park, Liverpool, L16 9LD. Manchester, 25th of May at 6 p.m. at Methodist Central Hall, Oldham Street, Manchester, M1 1JQ. London, 27th to 29th of May, 290 West Green Road, N15 3QR. Sheffield, 29th of May, 5:30 at Copthorne Hotel, Sheffield United Football Grounds, Bramall Lane, Sheffield, S2 4SU. For information, call 07947 476 649, 07401 664 977, www.globallightrevival.com. Come for your powerful Word of God, awesome Bible teaching, healing, deliverance, prophetic word, spiritual and physical breakthrough, impartation from the Holy Spirit. Come and be blessed. All are invited. Holy Spirit Conference. Come and experience the power of God.